The sun is so bright that I almost need sunglasses to do this recording, but daylight in the end is the best light to record your vlogs or movies, so we'll start with it. What I think that's amazing about the IT industry is that literally everybody that's working in the IT industry loves coffee. When I go to a customer, the first thing they ask you, do you want a cup of coffee? Yeah, of course, I love coffee. So let's start by having a cup of coffee, and after that, I will tell you how you get from nothing to a multi-region enterprise network in Azure. That's a good cup of coffee. I really like the lattes. So let's talk about networking right now, and especially multi-region enterprise-grade networking. What I most of the time tend to do is design my first region and replicate that design into the other regions that will come. So let's start by talking about a single region. How would we design that for an enterprise? Microsoft has a great principle for this, and that's called the hub-spoke principle. And this is a principle where you have one hub network and you can connect multiple spoke networks to this. A spoke network could be a network that's dedicated to a line of business application or a development stage, for example, your testing stage or production stage. That's all up to you, but keep in mind that we have a maximum of 50 peers per network. So at a maximum, we can have 50 spokes network connected to one hub. Let's have a look at the hub spoke principle for our first region, West Europe. What I designed for this region are three networks. We have our first network, the first spoke. It has an address space, it's a /24. Keep in mind that address spaces may not overlap in this principle. So it's so when you're going to work with this principle, make sure that you have a good administration for your IP addresses. We have a second virtual network that's also a /24. And both those networks are connected to the hub network. And the hub network holds a VPN gateway. And we will get soon to that. And we see that the spoke networks are connected with VNet peering to our hub. And what's great about this design is that we can have multiple spoke networks for a line of business applications. And we have one hub network. And in that hub network, we can put a network virtual appliance or an application gateway. A network device that is leveraged by multiple line of business applications. For example, a web application firewall. We can put that in our hub network. And all the spoke networks can use the web application firewall that's in the hub network. Up until now, I only talked about the address space of a virtual network. We didn't talk about subnetting yet. If you have a virtual network per line of business application, you could create a subnet for each tier of your application. So you could have a subnet for your web tier. You could have a subnet for your data tier and also a subnet for your application tier. By doing that and applying network security groups to those subnets, you create a secure environment. In this design, I only use the default subnet to make it simple in my demo that I will show you soon. And what I earlier said, I try to replicate my design into the other regions that will come. So when we have a look at our secondary region, North Europe, you will see exactly the same design. The only thing that's different are the address spaces of the virtual networks that we create. What's interesting is the hub network. In the hub networks, we will have VPN gateways. And between those VPN gateways, we will have a VPN connection. And we use that VPN connection since VNet peering over multiple regions in Azure is not supported yet. So if you have multiple virtual networks that are living in different regions, at this moment, the only supported way of connecting them is by using VPN. So now let's have a look in the Azure portal of how I've configured this thing. So I've created the resource group Azure Vlog VNet Demo, and this is the resource group where all the VNets are living in. And what you see is that there are two hub spokes, one in West Europe and one in North Europe. Let's have a look at the spoke network first. Well, what you can see is that there is currently one VM connected to this network. And I will use this VM later on in this demonstration to show you that the thing I'm telling you about now is actually working. This network only has a default subnet. As I said earlier, I only have a default subnet right now. Of course, when you have a line of business application, you could create subnets here for each tier of your application. For this demo, I would like to keep it simple and only have a default subnet. In this subnet, my virtual machine is deployed. Let's have a look at our VNet peering. What you see here is spoke 1 to hub 1. This is actually this connection, where we connect our spoke to the hub network. And when you create a VNet peer, you have to configure it on the spoke network and on the hub network. We are now looking at the configuration on the spoke network. What we see here are a couple of options that are set up. And one that's interesting to mention is use remote gateways. What this does is it allows the virtual network to use the gateway that's in the hub network. And as I showed you earlier, we have the VPN gateway in the hub network. And this setting allows the spoke network to use that VPN gateway that's running in our hub network. Let's have a look at the other networks. I have another spoke network. Well, that one is exactly the same configured as the spoke network that we saw yet. So let's have a look at another interesting network, our hub network. And what you see is that there is a gateway running in there, and I also have a VM deployed over here. Let's have a look at the peerings. Here we have the configuration of the VNet peering to the first spoke, the network that we saw earlier. And the settings are configured different over here. Here only allow gateway transit is enabled. And this actually means that the remote network, the spoke network, is allowed to use the gateway that's running in this network. So very important that this one is checked. And that's actually the hub spoke in our first region, West Europe. We have exactly the same hub spoke configuration deployed in a secondary region, North Europe. But now let's have a look at the VPN gateway that's running in West Europe, because this is actually the magic that glues those networks together. When you look at the configuration, it's actually a quite simple gateway. It's the least expensive SKU. BGP ASN is not required for this, so it's not checked. When you look at the configuration, just as VNet peering, we also have to create the connection on both sides. Let's have a look at the VPN connections. I have two connections configured over here. The North Europe to West Europe. one connection to connect our North Europe hub to the West Europe hub. And the secondary connection is to connect our West Europe hub to the North Europe hub. So let's have a look at the first connection. The North Europe to West Europe connection. What we see is that two gateways are involved over here. The North Europe gateway and the West Europe gateway. There is actually data flowing. The status is connected. When you configure the VPN connection, you have to enter a shared key. This is a key that's used to encrypt data. And the key has to be the same in both connections. Also have a look at configuration. BGP is disabled. We don't require that for this demonstration, so it's disabled. And that are actually all the settings that are there for this VPN connection. It's actually not that hard. And when we look at the other connection, we see that the location for this connection is West Europe. For the other connection, it was North Europe. We also see the same VPN gateways over here. Also, BGP is disabled in this connection. Those connections are actually the same. The only difference is the location where it's living. So, now we have seen the connection. We have seen a VPN gateway, and there are two IP addresses in there. In this case, we use the VPN gateway within Azure. But the VPN gateway can also be used to connect your on-premise site to Azure. And that's where you need the external IP address. You can hook up your on-premise router with an IPsec connection to Azure and use that public IP address over there. So what I have done to demonstrate to you that this thing is working, I deployed VM in West Europe. And that one is living in Spoke 2. And I've created a VM in North Europe. And that one is living in Spoke 1. So when we want to establish a connection between those VMs, traffic will first flow to the VPN gateway of our hub. From our VPN gateway, the traffic will flow through a VPN connection to the VPN gateway in the other region. And from that VPN gateway, the traffic will be routed to the Spoke network where the VM is living. So let's establish that connection and see that this solution is working. I'm currently logging into the VM that's running on Spoke 2. Now I have a VM that's running on North Europe, and that's in Spoke 1. And that's the 10.0.0.4. When I do a ping to the 10.0.0.4, we'll have reply. So this connection is working. One thing that might be interesting to demonstrate to you is how our VM in our Spoke network is getting its routes. When we go to the Azure portal and we go to the network interface of the particular VM, we have it over here. We can see the effective routes. We can see the route table that this VM is using to route its traffic through the Azure networks. What we see over here is that the VM is getting routes from the virtual network gateway. We see the address prefixes, and we see that the 10.0.0/24 is in here. So what this actually does is it tells our VM that if you want to go to an IP address that's living in this subnet, you have to go to the virtual network gateway. And this virtual network gateway knows how to handle that traffic. It will route it to another gateway, and from there it will be routed to the Spoke network. It knows its routes. So with that, I would like to end this demonstration. So I think this is a good structured way of having your network spanned over multiple regions. If you have any questions, please ask them through the comments. I'll gladly answer them. If you liked this video, please hit the thumbs up button. And of course, subscribe to this channel. I see you in the next Azure vlog. Bye.